And now 16 WAPT weather with Chief Meteorologist David Hartman.
Over the weekend, looks like a squall line, a narrow line of thunderstorms will be crossing the area between midnight Saturday night into the wee hours of the morning Sunday, 4 a.m., damaging wind gusts, and it's the type of situation, especially in the northern part of the state, that there could be a weak spin-up tornado. So something to watch, but there should be some pretty torrential rainfall and strong gusty winds during that time frame as it moves through. As far as record highs on consecutive days, it's over. The clouds and showers arrived too early, and we did not set a record high temperature today. In fact, the rain has cooled us down to 67. And what's interesting, the last couple of days, temperatures have been in the 40s and 50s to our north. They're actually warmer than us today. The warm air has surged to the north, has not rained up in the Delta yet. They'll get some rain later on and they will cool back down. You can see where it has rained and has not. Temperatures are warmer where there has been no rain so far today. The front is close by. It's just off to our northwest. It's still pretty chilly across most of Arkansas. We had that little disturbance move up from the Gulf Coast today. We were expecting the round of rain. That'll continue into early Friday evening. Then the rain will diminish, and then it'll be late tomorrow night that this upper-level storm system back over the Four Corners region tonight will swing a cold front finally through. So we'll see cooler weather for Sunday, but it looks like rain. So finally we get the nudge, this high pressure, this record-breaking heat pump, if you will, gets a nudge off to the southeast. And of course, making the change is when we'll see that squall line. Now, the best chance of the strongest storms is up here in the Delta of Arkansas and Mississippi, but certainly the chance of an isolated severe storm down into the Jackson metro area. But it looks like everybody should see a nice line of rain move across the area. And then on Sunday, as the front is over southeast Mississippi, there could be thunderstorms redeveloping in the afternoon. And it looks like we'll see some rain as a little disturbance moves up along the cold front. So Sunday could be a dreary, cooler day with periods of rain, possibility of temperatures in the 50s. That'll be a change. So into the afternoon, you can see how the rain diminishes into the evening, into the overnight hours. The sun will break out Saturday afternoon. That'll get us in record high territory again. And then after midnight tomorrow night, you can see the line, the squall line coming out of the Delta, swinging through while you sleep. And there's that next disturbance moving across Sunday with a cool rain, and it does look like rainfall totals will really add up once again with the storms moving through. A couple inches of rain possible through Sunday evening. Early evening rain diminishes, 64. Winds tomorrow, 15 to 30 in the afternoon, and there could be some wind gusts up to 40 miles per hour. Record highest possible. There's a chance of an isolated afternoon thunderstorm. Squall line moves through after midnight, and then we'll see additional rain redevelop with cooler temperatures on Sunday. Right now, Monday looks like a very nice weather day. Next week, Tuesday and Wednesday, rain and thunderstorms, and a cold front moves through sometime on Thursday. Look at that low temperature at the end of the 7-day period. As March arrives, colder temperatures return.